Hello guys, welcome to this video. It has been a very changing and shifting political climate in this country. In the past, we have seen protests that are modeled upon political interests and revolve around political leaders. But Gen Zs are willing to change the narrative of history. Indeed, history is changed when touched. The former Chief Justice Willy Mutunga has joined the Gen Z's movement, and he was today present, as shown by the following clip.
Kwingineko ni kwamba mkurugenzi wa mashtaka ya umma Renson Ingonga amewataka wanaoshiriki maandamano ya kupinga mswada wa fedha kufuata taratibu za sheria wanapoandamana, la sivyo watachukuliwa hatua za kisheria. Kulingana na Ingonga, baadhi ya vijana wanaendesha maandamano hayo bila kufuata taratibu zilizoko kisheria licha ya katiba kuwaruhusu kuandamana. Mwakilishi wa kike katika kaunti ya Kakamega Elsie Muhanda amesema ni muhimu kwa wabunge kutilia maanani maoni ya Wakenya kabla ya kupiga kura mswada huo. Walikuwa wakizungumza katika kanisa la Friends Handindi lililoko eneo bunge la Shinyalu walipofungua jengo jipya la kanisa.
Mambo yote nasikia ikitendeka nini na nini, tutii sheria hata kama unafanya nini, hata kama ni maandamano. Maandamano bila sheria tutawashika. Na wale watu wakishikwa, msianza kusema ati wanalaumiwa serikali na dhulumu. Jiulize kwanza, hao watu wakishikwa walikuwa wamefanya nini? Katiba yetu inaruhusu maandamano. Lakini haijasema unaamka tu hapa na unaanza kuandamana. Kuna utaratibu. Usipofuata huo utaratibu utashikwa.
Tuangalie mambo ya fiscal policy. Tuangalie ile policy yenye itasaidia hata mwananchi. Unaweza kujenga darasa na kama mtu ana njaa. Sisi lazima tuangalie mwananchi. Shikarikario. Saa hii mkiona watoto wetu wametoka Miranganga Gen Z, hiyo inaonyesha tuko na shida.
As we have seen, the Gen Z movement is gaining more and more traction with each passing day. Many people are joining the movement and clamoring for better political environment and of course a fiscal environment. It is indeed surprising to note that key leaders such as Babu Owino have been ordered to shut up by the Gen Z's protestants, clearly illustrating the fact that this is more of an economic as opposed to a political matter. Indeed, most graduates, people getting out of learning institutions, find themselves with no opportunities. They find it very difficult for them to be able to survive because the opportunity structure is so flawed that there are no jobs for most of our youth. So most of these youth are living in multidimensional poverty. They are finding it very, very hard to put meals on the table. So they are in a very, very dire financial situation. Such people deserve what we call a relief and or also a welfare state from the government. But instead, the government is coming forward with brutal taxation that is costing a lot of stress to this youth and a lot of stress also to these parents. I think it is about time that the government realizes that things cannot be mismanaged for too long, and with time the right balance will assert itself. It is about time that the government realizes that it can no longer go on doing atrocities that no one is questioning about. So as we have seen, this movement has got the support of key leaders, key religion leaders across the board, The Muslims, the Hindus, the Christians, everyone is supporting the Gen Z's movement. This clearly shows that something is terribly wrong with the state machinery and the way the country is being governed. That is why we are seeing these types of protests. So, the youth have said no to economic mismanagement. The youth have said no to godfatherism for jobs. The youth have said no to nepotism. The youth have said no to corruption. The youth have said no to mismanaging state resources or channeling state reserves to private accounts. So this is really the battle that the Gen Z's are fighting. Looking at the parliament, it is very, very clear that the parliament no longer reflects the wishes of the Kenyans, because they passed the finance bill contrary to the wishes of most of Kenyans. So this means that the parliament is already controlled by the president, and this means that parliament is only an extension of the will of the president and not the genuine reflection of the will of the people. Indeed, the electorate reserves the right to, at any point in time, if they feel that their wishes are not being represented appropriately by their leaders, they can recall these leaders and we have other leaders. Indeed, a democracy is a rule by people, and the majority will always have their way, though the minority will have their say. So I believe this is a very, very appropriate opportunity for the country to move forward and to cure, make medicine for the ills that exist within the political subsystem of this republic. Thank you for watching this video. Like, share.